this section, we want to understand the difference between physical properties and chemical properties, and very related to those things, the difference between physical changes and chemical changes. So the first thing we want to look at is some physical properties. So here we have wax. Wax is a solid at room temperature. That's a physical property. When it's heated, it becomes a liquid. That's a physical property. This particular wax appears to be a whitish color. Color would be a physical property. If we look at water, for example, the water in this pot, a physical property of the water is that at below 100 degrees Celsius, it's a liquid. Higher, at a higher temperature, it becomes a gas. It condenses on the surface of this pot because the surface of this pot is colder than 100 degrees Celsius. So therefore, it becomes a liquid again. These are some physical properties. We could also note some other physical properties. It's clear. That would be a physical property. For this metal that you can see on the rim of the pot, a physical property might be that it's shiny. Or for this handle made of plastic, a physical property would be that it's black. So these are different types of physical properties. In all cases, we don't have to do any chemistry to observe these physical properties. So physical properties can be observed without a chemical reaction. And there are many physical properties, but to name a few, something like melting point or boiling point. And related to those things, state of matter. Solid, liquid, gas, or color. So there are many different physical properties that you could have for different things. So physical properties can be distinguished from chemical properties. So on the next slide, we have an example of iron metal and then rust, and we all know that iron can turn into rust. Well, the fact that iron rusts is a chemical property. So chemical properties require a chemical reaction to be observed. Oops. And some examples include something rusts, something tarnishes, which is very similar to rusts, something burns, or pretty much anything that can be denoted as a chemical reaction. So on a macro scale, here we have this iron becoming this rust, and that is definitely a chemical change. But let's look at it from a chemical perspective. If we have iron, Fe, solid, plus oxygen from the air as gas, yields Fe2O3 as a solid. And this is not a balanced chemical equation. It's just a chemical equation to demonstrate what's happening. At the beginning of the reaction, this is iron. This is the shiny metal. This is Fe2O3. This is the brown stuff that we call rust. And we call this process rusting. And when it's depicted this way, it is a chemical change because we've actually chemically changed from the shiny iron metal to the dull brown rust. So this is a chemical change, which is directly related to a chemical property. Note the fact that iron rusts is a chemical property. The iron actually rusting is a chemical change. Let's look at another example. Before, we showed this wax. And this wax is burning. Burning is a chemical property, or something being flammable is a chemical property. Wax is CXHY, probably as a gas when it actually burns, plus oxygen, gas, yields carbon dioxide, gas, plus water. And again, we're not worried about balancing this. And this is wax. We're not going to worry about how many carbons and how many hydrogens. X and Y just means some number of carbons and some number of hydrogens. This is burning. And this is, again, a chemical change because we started with this molecule, carbon bonded to hydrogen, or carbon bonded to itself and some hydrogens, and we started with oxygen bonded to itself, and we ended up with the carbon bonded to the oxygen and the hydrogen bonded to the oxygen. So they're no longer bonded in the same way. So again, burning is a chemical change. The fact that wax is flammable is a chemical property. Now let's look at some another example that we can kind of depict as a chemical reaction, but it's not really a chemical reaction. Let's look at this example. If we have water, liquid goes to water, gas. This process is called boiling because we have a liquid going to a gas. But this is not a chemical change, even though it kind of looks like a chemical reaction. This is actually a physical change. So the physical property would be boiling point. The physical change would be the actual act of boiling. But we have water going from a liquid to a gas. Why is this not a chemical change? People sometimes confuse this because it looks very different, right? Liquid water sitting in a pot looks very different than the steam coming off the top of the pot. So it looks like something has really changed, right? It has very different physical properties. This is a clear liquid. This is a, within reason, clear gas. However, this is a physical change because it's H2O on this side. It's a hydrogen, two hydrogens bonded to an oxygen. And it's also H2O on this side. It's still two hydrogens bonded to an oxygen. We haven't changed what things are bonded to. Here, iron started bonding with oxygen. Here, carbon and hydrogen started bonding with oxygen. In this case, we didn't change anything. So this is a physical change. So we've now seen the difference between physical properties, chemical properties, physical changes, and chemical changes. The last thing I'd like to do is just show you a quick slide on some other examples of chemical changes. In this case, we have copper metal interacting with nitric acid to form copper 2 nitrate. This is a chemical change. Copper was originally a metal, and it was interacting with other copper metal atoms, and now it's interacting with nitrate, and it's formed a completely different compound. Here we have wood, which is another hydrocarbon, cellulose, which is a carbohydrate, burning and forming carbon dioxide and water. So it's no longer wood, it's no longer cellulose, I guess. It is now carbon dioxide and water. Here we have meat cooking. And here the red iron in hemoglobin is being oxidized with the addition of heat and oxygen, and it turns this brown color. And there are probably many other chemical changes going on as well, but it's no longer the same molecule as it was before. And the same thing here, some molecules within the bananas are being oxidized by the air, causing this brown color to occur. So physical and chemical properties and physical and chemical changes depend on whether an atom or molecule changes into another atom or molecule, or if it doesn't. So if it doesn't, it's a physical change, like water liquid going to water gas. If it does, like iron reacting with oxygen to form iron 2 oxide, it is a chemical change.